Damien and Saskia V on Mix 93.8.
It is Monday and we've got Lawrence Oberholzer in studio. He's our financial guy. Any financial questions you have, you can send them in 0848220938. Lawrence, we are chatting about unsecured debt.
Yeah, that's one that most people don't like to talk about, is the money that you owe people.
Oh, so that's what it is.
Yeah, so let me explain what unsecured debt is quickly. Unsecured debt is any debt that you have that is not secured by an asset that underlines the debt. Like your bond, not unsecured.
Okay.
Your car is not unsecured debt. Unsecured debt is like credit card, personal loans, overdraft, revolving credit, clothing accounts, furniture accounts. All of that is your unsecured debt.
Okay. So how do we have to get rid of it? Is it okay to sort of owe money on your credit card every month?
Okay. So that's the first thing we teach people. When we sit with clients and we start working and helping them to take control of their financial situation, we teach them to get rid of their unsecured debt first. The reason for that is a couple of things. The first thing is unsecured debt by definition is the highest interest because there's no security for it. So the banks charge the highest interest, which then means your repayment per 1,000 rand debt is the highest of all the types of debt that you have. So that is what eats up your cash flow. So people sit and they're paying without even thinking, they're paying 3,000-5,000 rand a month onto this unsecured debt. So we want to get rid of that, so that cash flow can rather start building assets instead of paying interest.
What if you can't pay it off?
Well, we need to then find a way for you to have a little bit extra. And that's where the budgeting comes in that I spoke about last time. We need to help people budget so that they can create positive cash flow. And then we use our strategy that we teach people to get rid of this unsecured debt.
Okay, so there is a strategy, behind it.
Yes.
Okay,
so here's the strategy, quickly. So what we teach people is, firstly, write down all the details of your unsecured debt. So what you want to write down is, firstly, what is the outstanding balance? What is the term still left on your unsecured debt? And what is the interest that you're paying? And the minimum payment that you need to pay. Otherwise, they come and they start phoning you.
Yeah.
Once you have all of that, you then decide how much money extra you can afford by doing a proper budget. Then you take that extra amount and you choose one of those debts. Now, in the seminar, the Invest in Yourself seminar that we have on the 7th, we teach people how to decide which one to go for first. But usually it's a choice between the one with the highest interest or the one with the lowest term. You then put that extra amount into that debt and pay it off sooner. Once you're finished with that one, you take the normal payment that you were making on that one, plus the extra amount, and you put that towards the next one. Then you pay the next one off quicker. And then you start the snowball effect.
So you kind of do it one by one.
One by one.
Okay.
A lot of people try and pay off their debt by paying 500 Rand, 50 Rand more on this one, 20 on that one, 30 on that one. That takes way too long. You want to start building momentum. So you choose one, pay it off, move over to the next one, pay it off. And you'll see once you start building that momentum, people start paying off 2, 3, 4 of those debts every single month. So it starts going so much quicker as you start building that strategy.
It is fascinating. So if you have any questions about unsecured debt, so this is debt, so I've never known this either, that has no security behind it. So your car, if you don't pay off your car, they're going to come and repossess it.
Take your car.
Same with your house.
Yes.
If you don't pay your bond, they can come and repossess. So this is, if you owe 20,000 Rand in your credit card, there's nothing
Take. So that's unsecured.
You.
Therefore, they charge higher interest to lend out that
money. It's your highest interest. So there's no point if I owe 10,000 Rand on my credit card, but now I want to put extra money into my bond every month, but I haven't paid off my credit card yet. That's not really the right way of doing it.
First, get rid of the unsecured debt, which is the highest interest.
Damien and Saskia V on Mix 93.8.
We've got our financial expert, Lawrence Oberholzer from Retire Rich and Happy in studio. We're chatting about unsecured debt, which is basically debt that you have that is not secured by an asset. So not a bond, not a car. You're looking at credit cards, personal loans.
Overdrafts. Revolving credit. That's a very dangerous one.
Anything like that. So Anne says, how do you know what your current interest is with regard to your credit card?
Yes.
And does the interest come off at the end of each month? How does that work?
Yes. Okay. So Firstly, most credit card statements should show you what your interest is. If you can't see it on your statement, you can go into the bank, phone the bank, and just ask them. They need to look at what your interest rate is. There's usually two. There's a straight interest on your credit card, mm-hmm. and then your budget on your credit card also has an interest rate, and that's not necessarily the same.
The same, okay.
So have a look at both of those. What I always suggest to people, the budget side is like small little loans with different terms themselves. Mm-hmm. So see them as each one as a different loan. If you have three different things on your budget account, see them as three different loans and start paying towards that.
Okay. And then your interest obviously changes with the more that you
That's owe. Outstanding. Yes. So what they will do is they will say interest is calculated annually and then credited to your account monthly. So what they will do is, let's say you've got 100,000 outstanding, you've got a 20% interest rate, that is 20,000 Rand for the year divided by 12, which will give you 1,500 Rand or whatever the case may be per month, that they will then add to your credit card, and that will be included in the minimum payment you have to make for that month.
For that month, okay. Another question here, an anonymous one. Can I cover my unsecured debt with a personal loan and then pay the personal loan back?
Yes. Okay, so that's called loan consolidation or debt consolidation. So a personal loan is just another type of unsecured debt. So it's not a case of no, it's never a good idea, or yes, it's always a good idea. It depends on your situation. Here's what happens. If you can go and you take all your debt, you consolidate it, you take one personal loan, and that payment is less than what you would have on the different ones, then it could be beneficial for your cash flow. But what you must remember is you're going to pay more interest because the term is going to be longer again. So what you need to do is firstly make sure that if you do that, you take an extra amount from the cash flow you save to pay it off sooner. And secondly, don't make more debt again. Because that's what a lot of people do, is they consolidate, they save 2,000 Rand a month, and then they use the credit card again. And 3 months later, they've
they
got the consolidation loan with the credit card.
And that's why budgeting is so important. Oh, so is this why at the seminar, so the seminar coming up, the Retire Rich and Happy Invest in Yourself seminar on the 7th of April, we'll also kind of go back to basics and say, you need to budget, otherwise you'll just keep going in the same cycle.
You need to address the cause of it. The fact that you have unsecured debt means there's something wrong with your cash flow, that you don't have enough cash flow to cover your expenses. Therefore, we need to go back, fix that, and then we sort out getting rid of the debt.
Okay. You can go to Retire Rich and Happy. All the info is on there. The seminar info is on there
Everything
as well.
On the website.
You can have a look at the 5-step program from Retire Rich and Happy. You can also email. So if you didn't feel like asking a question today and you'd like Lawrence to answer your question, you'll do so personally.
Yes.
You can email info@retirehappy.co.za.
Is that right?
Yes. info@retirehappy.co.za. You can also tweet them anytime @retirerichhappy. But all the links are on the website.
On the website.
Retire Rich and Happy, all written out.
Yes.
retirerichandhappy.co.za. It's been fascinating, Lawrence.
Thank you. It was good to be here.
retirerichandhappy.co.za if you'd like more info. Otherwise, we'll also keep your questions. You'll be here in 2 weeks again.
Yes.
Damien and Saskia V on Mix 93.8.